It's a day of celebration. The Aboriginal flag freely available for public use at last. The powerful design was created in 1970 by artist and proud Luritja man Harold Thomas.
The flag talks about ourselves, the pride, the culture, our ancestry.
And officially adopted as the flag for our First Nations peoples in 1995.
The Aboriginal colours of the earth, the red ochre and the yellow ochre, are foremost, was foremost that this flag was celebrating the land we love.
But the flag's copyright was held by Harold himself, who then sold the rights for use of his design for things like clothes and souvenirs. Anyone who wanted to use the flag legally had to request permission or pay a fee.
We didn't realise that the Aboriginal flag was copyrighted. I think a lot of Australia didn't.
Laura Thompson founded the Free the Flag campaign when her company, Clothing the Gaps, received a cease and desist order for using the image. The movement gained huge momentum. Olympian Nova Peris, AFL greats Lance Franklin and Michael Long lending their voices to the campaign.
I think ask Aboriginal people what the flag means and it will be something different. But one thing we can all agree on is that it means a lot to us and that the flag is worth fighting for.
Now, in a historic settlement, the federal government has paid more than $20 million to secure the flag's copyright.
It's in a safe place where the Commonwealth will protect and be the custodian of it, and I like that.
The flag can now be used on clothing, painted on sports grounds, included on websites and in artwork, freely, more than 50 years after it was first flown.
It allows the Aboriginal flag to breathe a new life in itself, so it becomes definitely in partnership with the Australian flag, and that I love, that I love.
Freeing the flag, long fought and hard won.
We're just so excited that it's free, and to be honest, we weren't going to give up the fight till it was, and I'm just excited that today mob can use it and they don't have to worry anymore.
And Olympian Nova Peris has been a leading voice in the Free the Flag campaign, and she joins us now. Nova, you joined us on the show back in 2019 demanding the government seize copyright as a matter of national urgency. 2 years later, it's happened. How significant is this moment for you?
Oh, look, you know, there's nothing more rewarding in life if you set out to achieve something and, you know, the fruits of labour come to fruition, and that's exactly what's happened. And, you know, myself and Michael Connolly and Laura Thompson, who was behind the Free the Flag campaign and Clothing the Gap, when we all set foot in Canberra, lobbying all the politicians to say, hey, you guys need to be on the right side of history and give our flag the same equal rights as the Australian flag, and it can't be held up in a copyright debacle anymore. So to have I found this out yesterday evening was absolutely just amazing. It really was.
Yeah, I want to talk about that moment, Nova. You have worked tirelessly on that, also with the people you just mentioned. What was that feeling like, that all your hard work and the work of so many had come to this moment? Because there must have been times where you thought maybe this moment wouldn't happen.
We didn't leave any stone unturned, so much so that, you know, when we did go to Canberra one time, we went to the Cuban ambassador because there was an image of the Aboriginal flag in this Cuban painting. We wrote to the Governor-General because the Governor-General could use his powers to make rules for the flag. We wrote endlessly and plenty of sleepless nights and, you know, tossing and turning and thinking, how are we going to free the flag? It's not just for this generation's benefit, but it's also the acknowledgement of those that have gone before us and for the betterment of all Australians, because it's such an international, iconic figure.
This announcement was made the day before, January 26th. What do you make of the timing?
Well, I guess tomorrow, when you look at the symbolic but also the historic day, that it was the day of the Aboriginal Tent Embassy being set up in Canberra. And, you know, the Aboriginal flag made its way through Gary Foley to Canberra, and that was where the Aboriginal people said, yes, this flag is what we can, you know, identify with, and it's something that we want to embrace, and we want ownership over it. So there's a lot of symbolism attached to it. And tomorrow, as an Aboriginal person, we know we call January 26th for what it is. It's, to us, it's Survival Day. It's the day that we've survived the struggles of 230 odd years of you know, attempted genocide, and that is our day tomorrow. So to actually have that flag, which identifies us and our histories, and the strength and resilience is something that we as Aboriginal Australians should say, yes, the chains of that copyright is now gone and it's free for us to use. We as Aboriginal people, we also want a date where we can all embrace. And, you know, I look forward to being able to take on another challenge, and that's change the day. And I think I did say it once before that the 3rd of March was our Australia Act of 1986, and it's a day where the two Acts of Parliament, the British Parliament and the Australia Parliament, when Bob Hawke and the Queen Elizabeth came out and said, this is our day of independence and acknowledge Australia being a sovereign country. So maybe the 3rd of March is a day that we can all come together, have a holiday. It's still hot enough to play cricket and a barbecue, and maybe that's the day that we strive for as another campaign.
No, but what happens if Ash Barty wins the Australian Open? Can that become our day?
Oh, my God. Ash Barty, hasn't she been an absolute ripper? And just, just the way that she graces a tennis court, but, you know, how she just articulates how proud she is as an Aboriginal woman, but also as an Australian. So we as all Australians can't help but love Ash Barty, and I'm looking forward to her getting up and winning her Grand Slam here on home soil.
It's always a pleasure, Nova. Thanks so much for your time.
Thanks very much for having me.